Now let us state and prove a necessary condition for convergence of a series. What's the statement? If series un converges, then limit of un as n tends to infinity equal to 0. That is, for every convergent series, the limit of nth term of the series must be 0. Let us prove this. Let the series un be convergent. That is, series un converges is given to us. What do you have to prove now? We have to show that limit of un as n tends to infinity is equals to 0. As we know that the behavior of a series always depends upon its sequence of partial sums. Therefore, let us consider sequence Sn be the sequence of partial sums of the series Un. Now we are going to test the sequence Sn, whether it is a convergent or divergent. What is given here? Series Un is convergent. Since the series Un is convergent, then the sequence of partial sum of the series must converge. Therefore, series Un converges implies the sequence Sn converges. What do you mean by converges? When you take the limit of Sn as n tends to infinity, it must give you a real number. Therefore, let limit of Sn as n tends to infinity be L. Since limit of Sn as n tends to infinity is L, limit of Sn minus 1 as n tends to infinity is also L, because n is the larger value. Now, we know that Sn, what is Sn? Sn is the first n terms of the given series. That is U1 plus U2 plus U3, so on, plus UN minus 1 plus UN. What is the value of U1 plus U2 plus U3 plus so on, UN minus 1? U1 plus U2 up to UN minus 1 is nothing but Sn minus 1. That is, the sum of first n minus 1 term is nothing but Sn minus 1. Therefore, it is equal to Sn minus 1 plus UN. This implies, now take this Sn minus 1 to the left hand side. Then what happened? UN is equals to Sn minus 1. That is, UN equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. Now, taking limit on, what do you have to prove? We have to show that limit of UN must be 0 as n tends to infinity. Now, we know UN. UN is Sn minus Sn minus 1. Now, what do you have to do? We have to take limit on both sides. Taking limit on both sides, therefore, limit of un as n tends to infinity is equals to limit of sn minus sn minus 1 as n tends to infinity. That is, we have to apply limit for each and every term on the right hand side. Therefore, limit of sn as n tends to infinity minus limit of sn minus 1 as n tends to infinity, we know that limit of sn is L. Limit of Sn minus 1 is also L. Therefore, L minus L, that is equal to 0. Thus, if the series Un is convergent, then limit of Un as n tends to infinity must be 0. Note, from the above theorem, we observe that in a geometric, in a convergent series, the nth term as n tends to infinity must necessarily to 0. That is, series un converges implies limit of un as n tends to infinity is equals to 0. The condition is necessary, not a sufficient condition for series un to be convergent. That is, the converse of the above theorem is not true. That is, if limit of un as n tends to infinity is 0, then the series un need not be convergent. Let us consider an example. Consider the series un whose nth term is 1 by n. The series un whose nth term is 1 by n. Now find the limit of un as n tends to infinity. Limit of un as n tends to infinity is limit of 1 by n as n tends to infinity. As n tends to infinity, 1 by n becomes 1 by infinity. What is 1 by infinity? 1 by infinity is 0. But what about the series? What is the series? The series diverges. Therefore, this statement is only necessary but not sufficient. That is, the converse part is not true. Need not be true. Now we have a result. We just now we discussed necessary condition for a convergent series. Now we are going to find a result which suffixes for divergent series. That is, sufficient condition for a divergent series. If limit of un as n tends to infinity is L, not equal to 0, then the series un diverges to plus infinity or minus infinity according as L is greater than 0 or L is less than 0. If L is greater than 0, the value of the limit of un is greater than 0, then we say that the given series diverges to plus infinity. If the limit of un as n tends to infinity is less than 0, then we say that the given series diverges to minus infinity. What is the converse part of it? Is it true? Is it true? The converse part is nothing but sufficient condition. What is the converse part? The converse part is, if series un diverges to plus infinity or the series un diverges to minus infinity, then limit of un should not be 0. Should not be 0. The limit of un is greater than 0 or less than 0, but should not be equal to 0. That is the converse part or the necessary part. That is, if the series un diverges, then the limit of un should not be 0. But look at the condition here. Look at an example here. The series un whose nth term is 1 by n. We know the series un whose nth term is 1 by n diverges to plus infinity. Similarly, the series un whose nth term is minus 1 by n diverges to minus infinity. But what is the limit of the two series? When you take the limit of un, it is 0. It is 0. See, though the series diverges, the limit of the nth term is 0. Therefore, this condition, namely limit of un is not equal to 0 as n tends to infinity, then the series diverges is only a sufficient condition, but is not a necessary condition. That is, there are series which are divergent and the limit of un is equals to L, which is equals to 0. Therefore, the condition is not necessary for divergent of a series. Now, let us recall the behavior of a series AN is similar to the behavior of a sequence SN. What is SN? SN is the partial sum of the given series. That is, sequence of the partial sum of the given series AN. It is always possible to decide whether the given series diverges or converges by finding limit of Sn as n tends to infinity. We know that if you want to check the behavior of a series, what do you have to do? We have to check the behavior of the sequence Sn of its partial sums. How do you find the behavior of the sequence of the partial sum of the given series? You simply write the sequence Sn. Sequence Sn is the partial sum. That is, sequence Sn is the first n terms of the given series. Now simply find the limit of Sn as n tends to infinity. Now we shall establish a necessary and sufficient condition for convergence of a series. We have already proved a theorem, a necessary and sufficient condition for convergence of a sequence. That was the theorem, namely Cauchy's general principle of convergence for sequence. Now we are going to establish a necessary and sufficient condition for a convergence of a series, namely Cauchy's general principle of convergence for series, which states that a necessary and sufficient condition for a series An to be convergent is that for a given epsilon greater than 0, there exists m belongs to n such that modulus of An plus 1 plus An plus 2 plus so on plus An plus b is less than epsilon. For all n is greater than or equal to m and p is greater than or equal to 1. This is the statement of this theorem. Let us prove this theorem now. So theorem is Cauchy's general principle of convergence for series. The statement is a necessary and sufficient condition for a series An to converge is that for a given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a natural number m such that modulus of An plus 1 plus An plus 2 plus so on An plus p is less than epsilon. What is the sum? The sum is nothing but n plus 1th term to n plus pth term of the given series. This sum is nothing but n plus 1th term to n plus pth term of the given series. It is true for all n is greater than or equal to m and p is greater than or equal to 1, or simply say p is greater than 0. Or we say that a series An converges if and only if. We know that if and only if, nothing but there are two parts, if part and only if part. Or we say necessary and sufficient condition. The if part IF, if part is necessary condition, the only if part is sufficient condition. Therefore, a series An converges if and only if to each epsilon greater than 0, there exists m belongs to n such that modulus of An plus 1 plus An plus 2 plus so on plus An plus b is less than epsilon for all n is greater than or equal to m and p is greater than or equal to 1. What is the sufficient condition? Sufficient condition is the series UN converges implies given epsilon that exists m such that this modulus is less than epsilon. What is the sufficient condition? Sufficient condition is for a given epsilon that exists m belongs to n such that modulus of n plus 1 plus n plus 2 plus so on plus n plus b less than epsilon for all n is greater than or equal to m and p is greater than or equal to 1 implies the series An converges. To prove this theorem, we are going to make use of the proof of Cauchy's general principle of convergence for sequence. Proof: let the series An be a convergent series. we know that the behavior of a series always depends upon its sequence of partial sums. Therefore, let us consider the sequence Sn be the sequence of partial sums of the series An, where Sn is the first n terms of the series, namely A1 plus A2 plus O1 plus An. We need up to An plus B, up to An plus B. Therefore, consider Sn plus B. What is Sn plus B? Sn plus B is the first n plus b, first n plus b terms of the given series, namely a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus an plus an plus 1 plus o1 plus an plus b. What is this A1 plus A2 plus O1 plus AN, which is highlighted in blue color? That is nothing but SN. Therefore, next step is SN plus P is equals to this sum. The first N terms of the given series is nothing but SN plus what are the rest of the terms? AN plus 1 plus So on, plus an plus b. Now what shall we do? Let us take this Sn to the left hand side, transposing Sn to the left hand side. Therefore, Sn plus b minus Sn is equals to an plus 1 plus an plus 2 plus an plus 3 plus so on plus an plus b. What is given? The series an is convergent. Then the sequence Sn is also convergent. That is, the series an is convergent implies the sequence Sn of its partial sum is convergent. Series Sn is convergent. What is Cauchy's general principle of a convergent of a sequence? It says that a sequence An converges if and only if for each epsilon greater than 0 there exists M belongs to N such that modulus of An plus B minus An less than epsilon for all N is greater or equal to M and P is greater than 0. Or we say a sequence AN converges if and only if the sequence AN is a Cauchy sequence. Here we consider Sn. Therefore, when we say the sequence Sn is convergent, look at this here. A sequence AN is convergent if and only if sequence An is a Cauchy sequence. Therefore, when you say Sn, the sequence Sn is convergent, this implies and implied by. We have to write implies and implied phi. That is, if and only if implies and implied phi, the sequence Sn is a Cauchy sequence. We know the definition of Cauchy sequence. What's the Cauchy sequence? That is, if and only if. See, above condition is if and only if. That if and only if for each epsilon greater than 0, there exists M belongs to N such that modulus of Sn plus B minus Sn is less than epsilon for all N is greater or equal to M and B is greater or equal to 1 is nothing but a definition of Cauchy sequence. For that is, if and only if for each epsilon greater than 0 there exists M belongs to N such that what is the value of modulus of Sn plus B minus Sn? In the previous slide just now we have found the Sn plus B minus Sn as an plus 1 plus an plus 2 plus an plus 3 plus 1 plus an plus b. Now we are going to substitute the value of Sn plus b minus Sn here. Therefore, if and only if, what is modulus of Sn plus b minus Sn? It is nothing but modulus of an plus 1 plus an plus 2 so on plus an plus b less than epsilon for all n is greater or equal to m and p is greater than or equals to 1. That is, the sequence Sn is convergent if and only if modulus of an plus 1 plus an plus 2 plus an plus so on plus an plus b for a given epsilon and m, it is true for all n is greater or equal to m and p is greater or equals to 1. That is, the series an is convergent if and only if modulus of an plus b plus an plus, sorry, modulus of an plus 1 plus an plus 2 plus so on plus an plus b less than epsilon for all n is greater or equal to m and p is greater or equal to 1. That completes the theorem.